It's a sunny Sunday afternoon in San Marcos, and the Shady Rest Band is playing its seventh show in as many days. Having such a hectic schedule is normal for the Texas band.
Let's go. Let's go. We can't slow. I can't slow down. This boat doesn't stop for anything.
By virtue of its rigorous performing schedule, hilarious social media presence, and good old-fashioned quality songwriting and picking, the Shady Rest Band has become one of the best-known and most beloved bands in Central Texas. The band is based now in San Marcos, but its roots lie about 1,000 miles to the west.
I started the band in Mammoth Lakes, California, in 2007 with some friends.
Core members Nate Guthrie and C.K. Dangerbird share singing and songwriting duties in the band, which has seen multiple lineup changes since it was formed. The Shady Rest often features a rotating cast of guest musicians who dig the band's loose and friendly approach.
It went from like a 4-piece to a 5-piece to a 7-piece, and now it's just us two.
You're just looking for a picture with the band. It happens to us all the time.
The band members are well known for their between-song comedic banter, but they also have a solid reputation for musicianship with elements of folk, bluegrass, and Americana. They offer a rootsy soup of music that is uniquely Shady.
The best way to describe it, I guess, the biggest blanket is Americana, done the way that only you know how to do it, you know? And what we're doing is the only thing we know how to do.
Not long after arriving in San Marcos, the band picked up their first weekly gig, which they still hold at the famous Cheatham Street Warehouse, where George Strait, Stevie Ray Vaughan, and Todd Snyder all performed early in their careers. The Shady Rest Band saw limited success in California's Sierra Mountains, but the reception has been quite different in Central Texas. The group has built a fan base, and the music has been pouring out. Since 2012, the band has released 3 studio albums, as well as a solo project from Nate Guthrie.
The last record we did was a live record. We were the last live recording at the old Triple Crown here in San Marcos.
When the band is not on the road, you can often catch them performing in San Marcos.
We go out on the road for 2 weeks and come back, and it's like, oh, San Marcos, wonderful. And the river and just the people and just the atmosphere that San Marcos brings is, I think, really has helped me grow as a songwriter.
San Marcos has been good to the band, and they do their best to return the favor. The Shady Rest has been known to perform at house parties, block parties, and even the farmer's market. They also support local causes by hosting events in the city.
I love this. I love it.
I wouldn't trade it for anything.
There are times when I'm tired, but I'm not tired of it at all.
The Shady Rest Boys don't plan on slowing down anytime soon. They have well over 200 shows slated for 2017, possibly a new album in the works. For Bobcat Update, I'm Tyler Dumas.